So, good evening. It's 5:05, and welcome back. I hope we are all set for starting today's session. Today, we will be talking about how to collect customer feedback and how to use them, for your marketing purpose, and how to use that feedbacks for other services, other for your product as well, and for in future reference also. So today's session will be all about customers, their requirement, how to understand it, how to get the feedback from them, and what are the ways how to means how we can collect them, collect the feedbacks from them, and how usefully or optimize you can do with that, and how you can make that information useful to you and your organization and your team also. So today our topic will be given by Vinuta. She is one of our member from success customer success team, and she will be joining today. And I think so she is available right now. Vinuta, can you hear me?
Yes.
Yeah, good evening.
Hi, good evening.
Vinita is a member of our customer success team, and she's handling our clients, our customers, and she is dealing with them in a day-to-day basis. So I think she's the right person with whom we can talk about the ways of collecting the way of collecting their feedbacks, talking about the experiences what she's having with the clients, and how and transferring the data what she's getting from the clients to the team, to the sales team, to the marketing team, and in the whole process how we can use the data. So we will be talking about that. So before going to the main session, I want you guys to know about us. So and before starting the session, you should know that with whom you are speaking to and with whom you are talking and listening to. So I will be sharing a little PPT or kind of introduction so that you may be aware of it. So if you guys are feeling anything, you're not able to see my screen or my voice is not clear, just put a chat so that we should also know that our network issue, our network thing or connectivity is good or not. So if it's all good, then if something is there, you can put a chat on there on over there. So today's topic is how to collect and make a best use of your customer feedback. So before that, I want to talk about us so that you can be aware of what who you we are and with whom we are listening to. So we are Aritech. It's a SaaS platform for business operation, and it's from Data Aegis Software Private Limited. We are a parent company of Data Aegis Software Private Limited, a Bangalore-based company who has started our operation in 2015 with two major SaaS projects, EasyCenDy and Aritech. We have two products, EasyCenDy and Aritech. EasyCenDy is more focused on SMEs, SME and SMB businesses, and Aritech is more of customer from mid enterprise to enterprises. And we both are the product platform are used by 2,000 more companies across globe. And from January 2020, we have started deep into India and SEA markets also. So we have a couple of brand where we will be talking about all these customers today and their experiences with us and how we what are feedbacks we have got from all these customers. So I have mentioned all the clients so that you will be relating when Vinuta will present her PPT, you will be relating with the client. So we have worked with all these clients so that and this is the experience we will be sharing with you today, and how we have used all the experiences in our marketing and sales purposes also. So these are the few products we are having under Aritech. That is Aritech Pinpoint, Sales CRM, Dex, Mail, so on, Press and Social. All these are the product ecosystem of Aritech we are into, And these are the different topics which we will be conducting in the upcoming webinar, which we will be talking about sales and how to create an good CRM and how to use it for the sales and marketing purposes. We will talk about different products also and how these products can change your marketing or your sales functions in future days. So that is all there. This is the milestone we have achieved in this previous years and upcoming years, and what we are doing right now and how far we have came here and what all things we have, what all project we have launched and what we are about to do in future dates. So that's it. This is the Eritic live show where we are sitting down together and talking about different topics. So this is a talk show which is basically organized for marketing, sales and BD people and for the working professional who want to talk about and who want to discuss on different topics related to marketing, sales and the whole marketing ecosystem, what is happening, and especially in the current scenario where there are so much dynamic changes are having around us in the marketing aspect also. So we need to get updated. So this is why if you see in the online media also, there are lots and lots of webinars going on. And the main purpose, I think so, the webinar which is going on, it's the main purpose to educate people how to develop themselves in the changing environment. So our purpose also is the same, which we came in the name of Eritic Life, where we will be talking about different aspects of changing in the environment and changing the psychology of the customers, changing in the market psychology, customer psychology and all that. So this is a small introduction about this, so that there should be a two-way communication in the upcoming webinar. If you will be joining us, we will be happy to have you in future. So that was a quick introduction from my end. Now, without wasting any time, I will stop sharing my screen and I will make Vinuta host, so that she will be sharing her PPT or information onwards.
Yes. Thank you for the introduction. Firstly, this is Vinuta from the customer success team of Eritic, and I would like to present my viewpoints about how to use customer feedback for your benefits. Let me share my screen and begin with this. Sonika, can you see my screen?
Yes. There's something glitches, I think, so going on.
Yes. This is the topic for the day: how to make the best use of your customer feedback. And this is my name. Initially, to begin with the introduction, I want to let you know that customer feedback is the best way to find out what your customer think about your product or service. We all create products with the perspective that end user likes it, but there will be a gap between what we have produced and what they are expecting from us. To bridge this gap, it is very important to take the feedback and implement the changes into our system. Secondly, how can we get it? Whether it is in the form of survey responses, or we can use the social platforms that we have, Instagram, Facebook, or any other media like LinkedIn, or use your own, we have our own chat system from where we can get these customer reports, and we can take the feedback and channelize it and try to implement the changes into the system. Yes, after getting the feedback, we need to analyze it and improvise the product so that it is user friendly. In that way, we could see that our business is going in the right direction. It is a small introduction of the topic. Now, getting into the topic of discussions, I have segmented into four different sectors. Initially, we will be discussing why customer feedback is important and what are the benefits that we get out of it and what are the best ways to get the feedback from your customers and smarter ways that you can use the customer feedback. Initially, why customer feedback is important? Yes, it points out aspects of your product that needs improvement. Yes, whatever product you have developed, I am very sure you would have a team of people with whom you would have discussed many things before releasing it online. But you, so that it is very difficult for you to find negatives out of the product. But if you approach a customer and ask for the feedback, it is easy for that customer to find the negatives and give it to you. This will add to the improvisation of that particular product or the service. Secondly, listening to customer feedback makes customer feel involved and important. Who don't want to be heard and felt important? We all do e-commerce purchases or shopping. Whenever we give some feedback, if the feedback is responded, we feel heard and we tend to go back to that site or suggest that to other people. Same is the case when it comes to your customer as well. Whenever customer gives any genuine feedback, if you respond to it, if you take it in a positive way and bring some changes to the system about your product or the service that you are providing. Good feedback generates personal recommendation. As we all, or the service, we all go by word of mouth rather than the suggestion of an expert, because if we have any problem in future, it is easy to reach the advice. So if you create a positive, loyal customer, then it's easy to get more customers. Very important you create a positive feedback. For that, you have to try hard to give the best and give what the customer is expecting from you. Fourthly, it helps you convince the customer to come back for more. Just in case you imagine you have a new customer who is already happy with your service for a tenure of time, then he has a new requirement. He will definitely come to you rather than approaching the peer competitor, because he feel comfortable and heard at your place than the other person. But if in case the initial experience with that person or with that company did not go well, even the customer would think, when will my tenure end? When will this contract end with these people so that I can get away from this place to another place? This will chase the people away from your system rather than coming to your towards you. So to gravitate more people towards you, you should try your best to give the best possible service at each point of time, especially in the beginning of your services, when the customer is viewing you as entirely fresh. Fifthly, even bad feedback can be used to sell the product. How do we do this? Suppose you received a bad feedback about your system on your site itself. Suppose there is a platform, a chat support or a feedbacks box that you have provided where customer can write in. So that query will definitely come to you directly. You can either tackle it by directly contacting that person or doing something about it. If in case there is no feedback platform on your site, then the customer might reach social platforms and write ill things about your site, about your product or your service, how pathetic it was, his experience was. In that case, it is a reconcilable loss to your product and you can't change it on their side. But if you create a platform and give it to them and respond to them, they will feel heard and they will feel we can solve our problem here itself, and they'll come there itself. One more thing, you might feel there might be negative comments on my site as well, but if you keep that at your site, people will feel that this site is transparent. They are keeping even negative comments as well as positive, and they feel you are trustworthy than any other people. Also, if a problem comes to you and you are unable to resolve it, you can tackle it. You can either give a discount on some of the products so that that person feels, rather than my problem, this was a small miss from their end, so I can adjust it. So you have tackled it in a good way rather than having a major hit on the future. Lastly, feedbacks helps you acquire new customer. Yes, as I told you earlier, we all Before purchasing any electronic merchandise or before going to any services, we all go online and check for the reviews. May it be a small product or a major one. But the same is the case of your customer. They will also go by the reviews of already used, like of the persons who have already used the system, who have already used your product. So try to create a positive feedback and positive impression so that it helps you in the future. There is a great saying said by Jeff Bezos of Amazon, who says, if you do build a great experience, customer tell each other about that. Word of mouth is very powerful. As we already know, we would have had a best experience purchasing online from Amazon. They have hassle-free returns and hassle-free policies that makes us go to them more than going other e-commerce platforms which are easily available today. They have set a benchmark in this category for the same reason. They believe in customer support more than anything, and they try to give it their best. So I want to move on to the next topic. What's the benefit of gathering the customer feedback? Listing it one by one. Improve your website. So you have a product, you have a SaaS product, you have designed your website. You know each and every options present in your website clearly, and you think it's perfectly fine. After some course of time, you observe that there is something lacking in my site. I have to improvise it compared to my competitors. You improvise it, but this improvisation did not go well with certain set of customers who were already acquainted with your site. But how do you find it out? You can create something called exit survey in place of abandoned carts and in place of successful completion of the purchase as well. There you can pose a question like, what did you like about the site, or what didn't go well in the site? As we know, 70% of e-commerce sites are suffering from abandoned carts. At least this review from them will help you to make the website more versatile and useful. Like this, you can stand out from rest of your peer competitors. Secondly, tailor the offer to needs of your customers. Yes, you are producing the products for the users. Suppose you created a new technology or new useful thing which you found as eye-catching or useful. But if your potential customer did not find any value in it, then it's a total waste. The amount and the man hour spent on it cannot be regained. So it is very, very important to understand what your customer exactly needs before giving it to them. So anytime you are creating anything, on the first hand, try to take the customer feedback and opinions and try to give them what they require, then to provide what we have for them. Improve your customer satisfaction. Yes, a satisfied customer is nothing better than new customer. I can tell you, it's very difficult to get a new customer into your site. We invest so much on marketing strategies. We might send PPC campaigns, email campaigns, and other things just to attract more customer traffic. But if you have one loyal customer, that customer will refer other customers, and we can get more customers easily into our site. For this purpose, importance should be given to make the available customer into a more satisfied one than to attract new customers into your site, because loyal customers can get you more people than branding. Understand how customers find you. As I told earlier, we are spending so much on 10 different channels for advertising purposes. But if you take an initial feedback of the customer, whoever reached you for business, like how did you find us, then you can sort out and find out of 10 channels, one or two channels is working well. One of two channels is going well, like attracting more customers. So you can cut down the cost that you are putting on all the 10 sites and focus it on only those two sites to gain more potential customers. And this is the best way. If it is working positively, then it is the best way to grab more customers towards you. Create more useful content. We all are looking for content. As we already know, we have a team of people who work on this content, because In inbound marketing, it's very important to create useful content. If you post a useful content, from that content, they might end up landing on our page, and that person might become a potential customer in future. Thus, all this can be done on only one basis. The content need not be huge, but it should be interesting or useful. Only then it can attract the attention of the customer. So it's very, very important marketing strategy to content, like create more useful content. But how do you know what is useful and what is not useful? For each content that is posted on the site, if you can attach a feedback, if you can take the feedback of the customer, they will let you know, was it helpful or was it not helpful? Based on that feedback, you can improvise and try creating more useful content on your site and grab the attention of the people. Then validate buyer persona. Yes, we all are thinking buyers are of some kind of people. We all have this assumption alien of this alien person. We might think, for instance, he might be the marketing head of some big company, or he is from this place, or he will be doing this kind of a work. Only those people will be interesting. But if you take a customer feedback, at the end of the feedback, you will come to know that that person was not head of the marketing. He was the owner of a small business, and he himself was interested in this aspect to reach more people. For example, in Aritic, we have more people who have small businesses as well as full-fledged businesses, MNCs. So we entertain both of them in their own work, and we try to help them in each ways to achieve their motto. Each of them come to us with different mottos, and as per their needs, we will help them. Similarly, some will be tech-savvy people who will consume less time and will understand things in one go. And sometimes people will take more time to understand, but their involvement is more. We feel happy to help them because they are learning along with us. So it is very important to validate your buyer. Who are your buyers? What kind of people are you attracting? In that case also, only if you ask for a feedback, you will come to know what kind of buyers are you attracting, or what kind of buyers do you already have. If you have that list sorted with you, it is easy for you to target such people out of all the bunch of lists that you have and get more potential customers into your list. Bill Gates, who doesn't know him, one of the most successful person on earth today, he says, your most unhappy customers are your greatest source of learning. One irritating part of Microsoft installing a Microsoft product, Windows, is that it keeps asking for Windows updates each now and then, every time. So initial part of phase, I was also feeling irritated, agitated. Why this comes every time? Why is it coming? Why is my system creating a problem? I don't want any updates. But later part in time, I understood that they didn't sell me only product. They are keen on giving me the best possible service. They want us to be updated with everything that is possible. Sometimes we get 1 GB, 2 GB updates from these people. Also, they were kind enough to upgrade all of us to the Windows 10 free of cost until 1 year tenure. I was also a part of this sector in the initial phase of my career. So I deeply respect their service-oriented mind, and they definitely do not compromise on quality. They only hire the best people and provide only quality services. That makes them stand out of the crowd. Best ways to get feedback from your customer. There are 100 other ways, but I have sorted few of them. Initially is email survey. Email survey, we can send a link in the survey and take the feedback. Or at the end of the abandon cart, we can send the survey. But how big the survey should be, how small the survey should be, that is dependent on you. But psychologically, if you ask me, when you are ending up buying a product, you would not like someone giving you 1 page or 10 page full of questions and asking yes, no, yes, no. Yes, that is a painful task and not a feasible one. Instead, you can pick 4 to 5 questions and prioritize it and take the answer for the same and try to improvise it. And next set of questions in the next month. You can do it in a rotational manner and gather more things, feedbacks from the customer. Feedbacks boxes. As you already know, if you visit any site, you would see this box popping up which says, how can we improve your experience with us? How did you find us? Or how can you suggest us to improve it? Those boxes are feedback boxes. I think only sensible people will reach out there to write descriptive things, and consider this feedback strongly, and improvising on things will definitely add to the positives of the company. Reach out directly. There are so few more kind people who tend to write long emails with all their concerns directly to the product or to the company, with the hope that it will be resolved internally. They are not intending to create any negative impression about your brand. Otherwise, they would have used other social media platform to create a negative impression of you. They have reached out to you directly. So you should take the feedback directly from them, and you should reach out to them. If it is a potential customer who is already using your system and wants to share a feedback with you, if he is within the reach of your city, you can arrange for a lunch with him or her and try to talk face to face and understand the things and sort it out them and there. If it is a person out of the city, you can definitely arrange an e-meeting. Try to understand what they are heard. See, people, when they feel heard, they feel happy. So if you listen whatever they are telling, you will get the insight, clear insight of what they are looking at. And you can try and make them understand what is feasible and what you can do better to make it look better. One more thing is user activity. Yes, there are as you already know, each of the site provides maybe the SaaS products. They give 30-day free trials, which most of them tend to use. As you observed, some people will come to your site, create an account, use the system for 1 week of time, then they stop using it. This means your system is not serving their purpose. They have served everything. They were looking for something. They came with the hope of looking for something, but they didn't find it. They move out with the dissatisfactory attitude. So what you can do is, you can analyze this in a bunch. There are many other surveys or web analytics which gives you the compiled report. But if you want to look at the customer-wise report, this is the best way. You would already have the email ID of the person. You can reach out to them and ask them what actually didn't go well with them, which didn't make them as a potential paid customer. Or you can recognize a bunch of people who are showing this kind of a pattern of activity. Target them and ask for a feedback why they did not actually use it. And also see what they are using and try to initialize a marketing strategy to make them gravitate towards you back and make them use your system. This is one of the beautiful way of attracting more people. One more thing, usability test. Suppose you created a new feature. Don't give it for a testing to a technical person, because you are creating each of the aspects for an end user purpose. So select a person who is not very tech savvy and who is only acquainted with your system. Ask him what he want, this is the feature, use it and give me your honest feedback. That person would give you more positive insight or negative insight considerably than a group of 20 tech savvy people, because they are very much well acquainted with all of the features, so they might not give you the actual insights. It might lose that real-time experience. So if you give it to a non-tech-savvy person, that person would definitely give you the improvisation, which will in turn help you with the improvisation of the product. Steve Jobs from Apple, he says, get closer than ever to your customer. So close, in fact, that you tell them what they need well before they realize it themselves. Yes, he's telling, he's going one step above. He's trying to tell, before the customer could tell you what he needs, understand yourself in their place. Try to give everything that he would be looking for. He will not take second chances. As we already know, they only hire best and best of people to provide best of the services, because they want to ensure they give only best in the market. And we all know about their services, how they provide it. Though it might charge more, we go for it because of the services they provide. And their policies are also very smooth. So So because of his beliefs, their company is where it is today. Smart ways to use your customer feedback. Adding credibility. You got a positive feedback. This feedback can be great way of counterattacking the effects of negative commentary and can help to increase your business performance. You can add positive reviews and testimonials to your website, increasing the credibility, trustworthiness, and integrity of your product and services, increasing the sales. E-commerce works best when people trust a website, seller, or a brand, and honest reviews, which are highly visible, are one of the most effective ways of increasing trust. Okay, what did we shop last? How did we shop it? Did we read the reviews first? Yes, we saw the reviews and went to the place and bought it. So it is very important to create a positive review and positive impression about the brand to increase the sales. Showing you are responsive. Negative feedback can sometimes be good. Allowing negative comments, your website and social media pages reduces the likelihood of them springing up elsewhere and also gives you an opportunity to redeem yourself, replying with a polite, personalized and thorough response. This is a great PR move as it shows your customer that you value their opinion, accept responsibility and are actually listening to the feedback they are giving. Directing your evolution. Did your customer dislike a particular aspect of your design? Do they have a comment about your branding? Is there something they have suggested you could do differently? These kinds of comments are useful. You have batches of novice developers and innovators helping you to change with times. For the same reason, you will also find the feedback helps to make decisions about your business while keeping it viable. Serving as a business development roadmap. Feedback allows you to trust the direction you are going in. Instead of speculating on what you think or hope your customer wants, you will actually be giving them exactly what they have asked for, and you can continue in the right direction. This is one of my favorite person, Elon Musk. He says it's very important to have a feedback loop where you're constantly thinking about what you have done and how you could be doing better. Before I could end, I want to share one of the experience, like one of the thoughts about one of the great products, which is Amazon. From free two-day shipping to streaming movies and grocery delivery, Amazon Prime aims to make customer lives easier in just about every area. The company is always innovating and finding new ways to solve customer problems. It has also a responsive service team that is empowered to provide gift vouchers and 3 months of Prime service if anything goes wrong. Who don't want to be associated with them? This is the power of having a positive customer feedback. I can relate to you with this name because of their services, and also the streaming giant obsession with customer is biased on knowing them very well. Netflix collects a huge amount of data on customers to create hyper-personalized recommendations. It uses that data to help customers find their new favorite shows and to create award-winning original content. That is exactly what customer wants to see. By understanding customers and putting them first, Netflix can build on its own knowledge and provide them entertainment what they like. This makes Netflix stand out of their peers and is undoubtedly the best. So with these two reviews, I want to end this presentation,
and Sonika,
over to you.
Thank you. Vindu, can you put that PPT screen in front of us? That quote, I really like that.
Okay, sure. I'll do that. Yes.
So I'm not able to start my video because you are the host. Or you just can share your screen with that quote okay. In front of that will be much better.
Okay. One second. I'll make you the host once. 1 minute.
Thank you.
Yes. So, I think you can start your video now. Required, or should I share the screen?
You can share your screen, and meanwhile, we can on the audio video also.
Okay.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So that quote will be, and that was really good what we have prepared. So I want it to be in the screen. That will be looking nice. So thank you, Vinita, for sharing such a good insight with us. And really, we have some real good examples where company has proven themselves that how customer is the king, and the customer can really make a brand and destroy the brand. Or this is all word to word mouth which really matters, and the feedback is what we see reviews and social media communities where people talk about brands and people say their feedbacks and people say about their experiences in the whole thing. I've seen many examples where people type or like post a long blog or post about their whole experiences. I've seen many good examples about Uber also, about Myntra also, some bad examples also. So that. Yes. And people really engage with them. So that's a power of having a customer feedbacks. So I think so our audience, the people who are listening to us, get in a valuable insight that how to get the feedback from them and how to use it for us, for the benefit of the company, and how to grow in between the customers. So there is like a few questions which is there, which I want to ask you about. That what was your what was your experience in the being in a customer success team? How was your experience in it?
The entire experience was good. We have a very supportive team, and our manager is very kind and supportive. He'll share a more friendly bond than being bossy. So it gives us more freedom to go up to him if we have any plans for the team, for the improvisation. And also when we fall short, he will always ensure he's there for our support. So this gives us confidence to try new things, even with the customers. Even when the customer comes up with the critical issue, it's a tricky thing to say no or provide an alternative. We have been trained in very such a good way that we can handle it very well. I have learned many soft skills in this entire tenure of handling people. And we have seen we serve globally. So we have seen many people across the globe. There were at times escalations as well, because it's a live environment and a software. But at the end, we were able to crack it. And I can definitely tell you, Aritik will never give up on any of the requirement. We make sure we do it within the prescribed time. And we have always ensured to give the best possible customer support. We have a set of onboarding team where we also ensure giving them the best possible support outside our working hours as well, not only within the working hours. And our customers are quite happy because we have association of a customer since 4 years, 5 years, 3 years, with huge number, like they have a good frequency and bandwidth. Also, we have good references. Even during the pandemic, customers only helped us to gain more customers with their word of mouth. That is the kind of service that we are providing. Even when we are working from home, we are working in a more efficient way. We are sticking to the company's rules and policies. Reason, not because of frighten or anything. We share a very cordial bond within the company. I feel very happy, respected, and dignified to be the part of Aritik, especially to represent the customer success team.
That's really good. So it's like I am knowing you individually also, but other than when you talk with customers and when you talk with their solution, seek solution for that and talk about what's their problem are. So what is the psychology what a customer hold when he or she, the person, comes to you and talk about it? So what psychology they hold?
Yes, I'll tell you. Thank you for the question. The customer, there are two kinds of customer. One customer who use and wants to come to us to find solutions which they didn't find in the previous platform. So in that case, sometimes it's very easy, sometimes sensor is not available within us. So in that case, we might have to give special attention and follow up and try to do that. Small thin line is there where we try to make them understand and try to get things done parallelly. This is where we come into picture. One, other customer is not at all tech savvy. They are very much happy that what we are catering, but they are unable to use it. We have to handhold them for 6 weeks of time. We have to train everything from the scratch. And we extend our support more than the promised time sometimes because the person is somewhere little behind from other customers. For example, as I told in my webinar also, like there are few people who are the head of small businesses and not marketing head who do not know anything about automation, anything about the product, anything about how to use it. They just want their product to reach maximum number of people. This is their main intention. But they are very keen on using the product. In that time, it takes our extra effort and energy. They come with a perspective. Some will be like obedient, some will listen, some will be coordinating with us, do as and when we tell. Some people come with the thing like, I'm paying you, I want the things to be done. It is very difficult to get them to understanding that you will have to put some input. You will have to do some kind of a hard work. We are there to train you. We will be helping you to the best of the possibility. But at the end of the day, you should understand how to use the system and try using it on your own. If there is any glitch, any kind of hiccups, we are there to help you. We are there to take you through that process. But doing it from end to end will make it little difficult because at one stretch, we are handling multiple set of customers. And dealing with each set of customers differently is actually a challenging task. But we are trying to do it in a smoother pace because we have a very trained, like helpful backbone for us. Like there's a very good faculty of like team of people who will help me in doing it. So these kind of people are, there are many other people who are more tech savvy than us. They will be understanding things. Then they have a very good understanding of things. And that time we have to post confidently and try addressing them in their level. Sometimes we have to go below our level. Sometimes we have to gel up. It's within the one or two talks, we will be gaining that understanding. After that, we will be working with them. This was one of my understanding about the psychology of the customer. Mm-hmm. But let me tell you, none of the customers, two customers are alike. Each of them needs a different kind of treatment, different kind of attention, which we are balancing from our customer success.
That is true. Which is also applicable in the sales part also and the marketing part also. You can't put the same marketing campaigns or same marketing psychology to the whole set of audience, it's a psychology game which we do. So we need to understand what's there inside the mind of a audience or a customer or what's the need. So it's the story is different for every customer. That's true what you have said. So I hope the whole scenario of putting the whole story together as a summary, I want to say that understanding customers, like Vinita also said, that gaining 10 customers just that and not making them happy will lead you nowhere, but the one customer will lead you somewhere where you are trying to get over there. So gaining a loyal customer is very important for any company, but how to get it and how to achieve over there is the difficult part. And I hope that we have helped you in that, and I hope that you will be gaining a lots of information and insight so that you will be implementing it in future dates. And in upcoming webinars also, we will be talking more about it with different people, different psychology and different topics altogether. So thank you, Vinita, for joining with me and talking about your experiences and your knowledge, whatever you are having. And you shared with us. So thank you for joining it. And I hope that we will be doing some same kind of webinar in future date as well.
Thank you. Thank you, Sonika, for the opportunity. Thank you for hosting this today. It was a great platform for me as well. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you guys for joining us. I hope that in upcoming session, you will be joining us back then also. And you guys have joined back sessions also, and you will be joining in future webinars also with us. And stay connected with us, and stay safe also in present situation, what is going on. So I hope we will be seeing each other soon. Till then, bye-bye. Take care. Bye. Bye, Vinata.
Bye, Sonika. Thank you.
Thank you.